Initialization commands. In this lecture, you will learn the general node modules that we will use to move into the Firebase database. These modules will be extremely handy in working with Firebase database in our upcoming lectures and your projects. There are two main parts. One, you get data from the database, and two, you post data to your database. But first of all, you must be in the right position on the whole JSON list to either post or get, and the following modules helps you with it. I hope you already know how to deploy a Firebase function and also how to create simple intents and entities using our Dialogflow application, which was previously called API.ai. Anyways, if you don't know, no need to worry. You can either take the introductory course on Google Assistant, or you can follow the links in the resource section for documentations given by the Google developers themselves, which will be more than enough to get you started if you are not an amateur to computers. First, Firebase init. To enable Firebase database from your command prompt, you will have to use Firebase init. And then enable Firebase database using your spacebar toggles. Database function. Database function can be called with no arguments to access the default apps database service inside Firebase. You can also access it using an URL to obtain the data service of the app based on the database's URL. Since we will be using our application's associated Firebase database, we will leave it empty. Suppose we are going to access some external database, then the corresponding hosted URL must be given here. Ref. Ref returns a reference to the query's location. This is the function with which we will move through our JSON-like database. We can move to a particular position by giving in the direction like this. Child function. This is again a function used to move from a parent location to any of its children in both ref and child. You can even give deeper slash-separated paths like this. Go online. As I already mentioned, Firebase could be of use to find whether our user is online or offline and perform certain functions based on the results. It can be used to clean up the current session with the user on the database or to continue once the user comes back online. All these capabilities comes under the function onDisconnect. Now, what if we want some user to not receive any data for a specific period? In that case, the following functions will help. Go offline. The client automatically maintains a connection to the database server, which will remain active indefinitely and reconnect when disconnected. However, the go offline and go online methods may be used to control the client connection in cases where a persistent connection is not desirable. While offline, the client will no longer service data updates from the database. However, all the database operations performed locally will continue to immediately fire events, allowing your application to continue behaving normally. Additionally, each operation performed locally will automatically be queued and retried upon reconnection to the database server. To reconnect to the database and begin receiving remote events, we use Go Online. This reconnects to the server and synchronizes the offline database state with the server state. This method should be used after disabling the active connection with Go Offline. Once reconnected, the client will transmit the proper data and fire the appropriate events so that your client catches up automatically. Summary. In this lecture, we learned about the necessary Node.js modules for Firebase database. In the next lecture, we will move into modules which helps us in sending and receiving data to and from database respectively.